ओके हाँ, तो हियर हाँ
आई टर्न ऑन ऑल द ड्रॉइंग्स.
लिंक्स ओके
ओके,
फाइन
दिस इज माय ड्रॉइंग.
हाँ फाइन
So for the like for the rebar, main rebar,
ओके
if I turn off the rebar,
हाँ
I can still see the empty space of the rebar.
हाँ हाँ सो यू वॉन्ट देम टू
But
गेट
when
फिल्ड राइट
I what's up?
यू वॉन्ट देम टू बी फिल्ड राइट
Sorry, sorry, I couldn't get you. What?
लाइक यू वॉन्ट दोज यू डोंट वॉन्ट दोज एम्प्टी स्पेसेस राइट
I want the empty spaces. I want the empty spaces because when I try to run the thing in the NCs,
या
this rebus have no problem at all because it has the empty space for it. Means
ओके
it doesn't collide with the concrete,
ओके
but
ओके
the links all collide with the concrete when I try to run.
द लिंक्स आर गेटिंग
I cannot run the mesh. The mesh giving me some error for the links.
ओके बट एक्चुअली इट्स एनालिसिस यू कैन डू इट इन एनालिसिस पार्ट नो लाइक देयर सम सेटिंग्स यू कैन मेक टू सी दैट जस्ट शो मी द एनालिसिस यू हैव डन
Okay.
हाँ तो इट्स टेलिंग सम रिइंफोर्समेंट एरर
After I suppress the link and the cobble reinforcement, then only I can do my running. I can run my NCs.
Actually, our problem in the analysis is related to the link. If we suppress the link, the result is okay. But if we activate the link, something's wrong.
Okay, fine, fine, fine. During this
So the
solution.
issue is the link. How to make it the link is not collide with the concrete body, concrete surface.
This is my analysis.
Okay, हाँ. So, हाँ, you have suppressed the link, right?
In this case, I have already suppressed the links.
Link, हाँ. What is warning? It's giving a warning, but error.
Roshan, I think you can activate back this the link and then show to sir how's the result.
Unsuppressed, okay, हाँ. वन और मोर एंटिटीज फेल टू मैश हाँ हाँ जस्ट हाँ हाँ मैंने एरर हाँ ओके तो फर्स्ट वन यू जस्ट ऑन द फर्स्ट वन लेट्स सी व्हाट इज दैट
The
वन
first one, the
फर्स्ट
first
वन हाँ
one.
फर्स्ट वन वन और मोर एंटिटीज फेल टू मैश द मैश ऑफ द बॉडीज कंटेनिंग दीज एंटिटीज मे नॉट बी अप टू डेट हाउएवर मशीन माइट बी सक्सेसफुल ऑन द अदर एंटिटीज ओके वन ऑफ मोर एंटिटीज फेल टू मैश तो मशीन हैज फेल्ड ओके तो हु गिव यू द आइडिया लाइक इतने सम प्रॉब्लम इन मॉडलिंग ओनली
What's that? Sorry.
सो सो हाउ डिड यू गेट टू नो लाइक सम इन मॉडलिंग ओनली देर इज अ प्रॉब्लम दैट वे आई एम मिसिंग हाँ
Try and error.
ओके यू कॉन्टेक्टेड द एंसर्स फॉर्म
I've emailed them
हाँ
and
हाँ
I've asked in the forum.
ओके
When I asked them, they say there is something with the contact of the link.
ओके 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 कॉन्टैक्ट हाँ यू हैव टू डिफाइंड सी वन वन मोर थिंग आई जस्ट वांट टू आस्क यू जस्ट वेट लेट मी हाँ डू यू हैव यू सीन द कॉन्टैक्ट मैसेज हियर सो जस्ट कम बैक इन द आउटलाइन जस्ट कम बैक हियर हाँ हियर यू जस्ट हाँ हाँ श्रिंक दैट हाँ नाउ यू गो टू कनेक्शंस या
Contact.
हाँ कनेक्शंस यू गो टू दैट कॉन्टैक्ट हाँ सी हियर ऑल दोज थिंग्स वन एटलीस्ट वन यू गो हाँ सो हियर हाँ वेयर यू आर गेटिंग द एरर एक्चुअली इज इन द लिंक्स राइट
Yeah, I'm getting for the links. The links will be like around.
हाँ यू शुड सी दैट लिंक्स विच वन
This one is a link.
हाँ हाँ सी कॉन्टैक्ट बॉडी सो दिस इज इन कॉन्टैक्ट विथ लिंक हाँ तो फाइन बट देर इज नो रिइंफोर्समेंट कॉन्टैक्ट नो
You mean so reinforcement?
Like see your this stirrup this this link is in contact with main by Dan named Daya, but actually that again it should be in contact with concrete column, right?
Yes, it should be contact with the concrete column.
So what you make is you have to select a contact, contact one.
This one.
Yeah. So you just see that. One second. What you have to make is what is in contact. The main by Daya is in contact. Target is target body. So the link is in contact with the main bar. And the main bar is again in contact with your concrete
they
column.
They will be touching. They will be touching each other.
Yeah.
The link and main bar. But so, I think the contact between the
so
link
I,
and
so
concrete
what,
isn't defined.
Yeah. So it should be, we should also be in, that should be also in contact with concrete column also, no? So then it would be realistic, right? Because all of them will be carrying the load.
Yes.
So all of them will be.
Mr. Abhishek.
Yes, sir.
I want to ask, if let's say it's appear like this, a contact region, 1, 2, 3, and so on. What is the meaning actually? Contact region. Is it something is wrong in the model or what? They want to we clarify the contact or what? This one actually.
Actually, contact region is the region here. What is telling you is really that. So when you make a contact, so your contact thing is there will be a transfer of stress, okay? So now what is happening according to your model is that the link is in contact with the stirrup, and but the stirrup is not in contact with concrete column as of now. So what I mean to say is you this all connections you have not made them, you have Diansys has created it automatically. So what I am suggesting is you have to make a manual contact. One, you can go to the contact region above here to select a manual contact. Means you it's a right click, create a manual contact, manual contacts or connection. Yeah, contact region there. What you do? Contact, you take contact. Now you select what you have to select each and every link that is in contact with each other, and target location will be your concrete body flesh. Okay, concrete flesh. You can select in that way also.
Okay, and then I have to select for the contact. I have to select the
links. No, all of them will be in contact only. Select box, select. You make them as a contact.
Apply.
Contact. No, where are the main bars?
Oh, should include the main bar.
Everything is in contact. Those both are in contact. They are finally contact with concrete body.
Okay.
So just see, all of them are selected. So
yes,
fine. Now what you do, select the target body. Now go for target region. No selection. Now you make unhide all the objects. Let your concrete beam also be visible.
I only on the concrete.
You on that concrete job. No. You make it unhide all. Show. Yes. Now select this.
All body.
Yeah, show all body. Yep. Now you select, you just come back again to that manual contact region you made, no? There. Yes.
Okay.
Just come there. Select the target body now. It will be your entire column. Entire column and that beam here. Entire that side portion. Select that this one also, cantilever portion also you want to select.
Mm-hmm. And the ground field.
Just see that. Compartment. Everything. Okay. Yes. Okay. Fine. Apply. So, now this is done. One more thing I wanted to tell. Just take your model, zoom it in this face here, the face of the beam here. Zoom this. Face. Turn face. Yes. Zoom it. Zoom it little bit. Zoom in. So this place is why they are showing red actually. You should take this little bit inside actually.
What, sir?
You have to take this bar little bit inside. This red color, they are the main bars, no? They will create problem in meshing. As you have to take, you should ensure that also. I'm telling you. Now you can run the mesh. Now you run the analysis.
For the previous, the previous contact region, which same error.
Same error.
But the thing is showing for the corbel, I guess. For the corbel reinforcement.
Okay. So yeah. So you once again you just you make this. I told you, no, I just told you now. You just make that correction, okay? Because once even I was doing when I was doing modeling, no, that portion should go inside. Is there a continuation like so those. That
no,
is,
no, there is no continuation. This one.
You create a offset there and just take that bar inside.
Okay.
In the space claim, you have to do that one. So. Just take 15. Okay.
And then for this part, I have to refill again, right? For the
just use a fill command there.
But it will fill entire section.
No. Just try. Just see once.
Okay.
Just check whether your bar is there or not. It's there. No problem. Okay.
Okay.
Now again, top face also in column also you have done the same thing. I think top face, column top face.
Oh, okay. Hello, sir.
Yeah, okay.
So I've done the I've done pushing it 50 mm, 50 mm.
Okay, so just check the connections part, whether the connections are there or not. Like, okay, just go below. Like you the one which you created.
Oh, the one I created. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So now just try. Just do the meshing first. And
meshing. Same. The error.
Just where it failed actually. So you on that error you just right click here on test. Right click, go to the object.
R2.
See, you can just see that something error you have done while doing that. Little bit you have to there some error you are getting. Because by machine it is doing that, no?
What? If I try suppress only this thing, I can see whether this is the real.
Okay. Yes. Fine.
Still there is a problem with the mesh.
Again you go to that go to object again, we see where, okay, where is the exact problem. Now machine problem, the software execution error occurred inside the machine. The process suffered an exception, ran out of usable memory. Oh, it ran out of usable memory. It means you have to just go to the options here. You there's a quick launch here, top right side, quick launch,
top
right
top
side,
right
side. Just go there. No, there, quick launch. Just type there solve process settings.
Sorry?
Solve process settings. Solve process. Process.
Process.
No, not D. You just have this. It's there, see, first one. Yeah, take me there. Now, what you do? You go to advanced here. Yeah. Advanced. Now you have GPU. Now you make this none as just select that none, NVIDIA will do it. Number of manually specify the NVIDIA. Just click manually, just once you click.
Okay.
So your PC is i7 configuration, I think.
i5.
No, okay. RAM
8 GB RAM.
Okay, it should not take much problem. Okay, you just again uncheck all those things.
What's that?
Uncheck, you just uncheck that manually. Uncheck again, you just select this GPU. Select GPU.
Okay,
just none, you make none. Okay, fine, just say okay and go. Okay, you say here, tell okay here. Okay, sometimes it this settings requires some refresh. Okay, just now once again you try analysis.
Still same
unusable memory. This one actually model wise error is not there, some software error is it is telling. It's giving some software errors actually. What to do now? You have to see unanalyzed ran out of usable memory. So now you again you specify the memory, now you change that. What you do know what I don't know, you just do the opposite. Take NVIDIA you do. And memory you assign randomly, you give about some memory. Okay, so we should should try in that way only now. Solve process, yeah.
Advanced, NVIDIA.
Number of, okay, manually. So how much MB would this go? Okay, one or just do 1000 MB. Let's see what will happen. Okay, then okay. Now again. Same thing again.
Why try?
More memory.
Sir, would increasing the mesh size help with this case?
Increasing the mesh size would not help, but decreasing would actually help it. Actually, because if you increase the mesh size, you know, some you have taken twists and turns in the reinforcement, there the meshing will not be correct, and at that region there is a maximum probability of error, energy error will be there. So if it is possible, whether if your meshing, if just see, you can reduce the mesh. Actually default it will be, I think it is taking 20 mm or what. If you are doing it for 5 mm, just check that, just go for 10 mm actually. Mesh, you just see meshing.
Okay, mesh.
Mesh, you open. Just go below here. Default, you see how much it is. Element size. Just click on element size. Default. So default.
No, I cannot click the thing.
No, no. You can just see. You select that.
Select.
You're not able to select that. Here you can click. Now you can select. Now 10 mm you go.
10 mm.
10 mm you go. It will take little bit time to load. Actually increasing the mesh size, what it will happen is your solvation process time will reduce. That is the only objective, and results will be approximate. See, now I think.
Now the problem is settled already.
Meshing actually problem will be there. So
depending
on your patience, if you are going for very low mesh also, it will take again some error came. No, you directly you did you solved again.
So I think the thing is because of the GPU maybe.
Just see. See, this say the same thing of error even I used to get during my projects. So what happens is once I do here, like if you're running, if you're using a lot of memory also, your computer will not have that capacity to derive the results. It will stop working little bit, it will be hanging. Again you do this same project in the evening or later, sometimes it will give you the result, because whatever memory you're using, no. So it also depends on that, because it is showing memory error. There is no error in the structure. Well, let's see.
So like for here, I have defined the context, right?
Yeah. You this is your
this
you, tell me.
This one I defined myself.
Again, what?
Like for the cobble, right, just now there is a problem with the cobble, since in this case I have already suppressed the cobble.
Okay, fine. Cobble.
So I'm not sure what's the problem with the cobble.
I think what you do is if possible you can you do it once more, you just check that. Okay, that cobble, some sort of small error, some curve will be missing or some edges while here and there it may take place, but I am sure that you might have done it correctly, but sometimes it is better to a little bit you do remodeling also. You just do remodeling, because geometrical errors tell me.
Face things like this one, it will go to 8%, 10%, 8%, 10%, and then the thing won't.
Yeah. It will take lot of time, no? Because see, one thing you could do here is you can stop the solution. Just stop it. Interrupt.
Stop the.
Click on that.
Okay. I've stopped the solution.
Okay. You stop the solution. Now what you do? Click on the solution. Solution part here. Right click.
Okay.
And right click.
It's hanging.
Okay, okay, I know. So so only I asked you a little bit. It depends on process. See, now only you can understand it is consuming your memory. So results will not, like it will be software, some error is there.
So actually that holo thing isn't necessary, is it?
No, not at all. I didn't, whatever you have done, no, it's absolutely correct. Whatever is there. And whatever, that one thing I told you, you have to take that reinforcement inside. Those things, if it is done, the model is perfectly correct now. It's not responding. You wait. Now you can close also. Wait. So actually what happens is that doubts, whatever you told now, it will not arise only because now you have taken it inside. You select the clear generated data. So always when you are solving once again now, always make sure that you clear the generated data, which means all the cache. The cache will remove. Okay, the cache will get refreshed. Otherwise, whatever you do, it goes on overlapping, whatever error. And again, if you are doing solving. Now, one more thing I can tell you here is go to analysis settings here. Just go there and just come below. Analysis time and little bit upward. So take it up. Step and time sequence. Auto time stepping. Okay, no problem. It's okay. No, nothing. It will come in explicit dynamics, not here. Okay. Means I was insisting you to reduce the cycles, number of cycles. Then only your solution may come fast.
Again, same thing. It came to A, and then
you
go back to the 2%, 4%,
6%, 8%, 2%, 4%. See, why it's happening? Because your the loads are getting established actually, and usually some your model is also complex. And now what we have done, we have defined each and every contact of the main and links as the concrete. So it will take time. It will take time, I think, because we have to wait a little bit. Ultimately it will show, but it will take a little bit time. So what you do, if we could not get that, at least if you search in Ansys firm also, they'll give the same thing. You go to Go process. I have searched all those things and I'm telling you guys, like whatever I have experienced, they will say the same thing. Go to solve process settings, change this and that.
Understand.
Same thing they'll tell, but model is a little bit big now. And this is your licensed version, right?
This one.
This student, software.
Student version.
Student version, huh? Okay. Because the number of
I'm getting like, as you said, it's taking longer, but there is a progress.
There is a progress. See, whenever it takes a lot of time, if it is taking without any error, see, you can just see what you do. Go to static structure here. I'm telling you, just go to static structure. Solution. It was 12%, right?
Just now it's got improved. Going back to 7 again.
See, you just come here and click on the green color, the progress. You just click on the green color progress. Once you click on the green color progress, just one click, left click, you can see here, like modeling, everything is done completely. Progress means this below part will be running many times. Overall progress will go on slowly. Below mathematical modeling, solving will go many times. Solving will be done many times in that way. You can see again, it will go now, again it will come back. I feel very happy, like you guys come and ask the questions, and whatever little I know, I can tell you. So it's a good thing. So actually, what's your feedback for this? I don't have much subscribers actually.
Actually, it's very, very good, and we the most important thing, like the link already, I think we saw already, Shana, the link issue. We got the call bonded.
Yeah.
Manually, like the contact agent assigned manual, and we can solve the link issue, I think.
Yeah, correct. See, what happens many times, no, in there are people who are good in ANSYS in India, many people, but many people, they don't show actually everything. They don't show, some people don't show modeling at all, because they there's some sort of things their supers sometimes some sort of tricks they want to don't show to the public actually. But I do modeling also and analysis also, and whatever error I face, no, I just show them also, and I just want to make sure that if error comes, one thing is when error comes to everyone, because we don't know the software exactly, no, how it is designed. So one thing is you have to correct the error and you have to move ahead. So which all softwares you use actually apart from ANSYS?
What's that? Sorry.
Which all softwares you are using apart from ANSYS?
For the structure, I think for the finite element method, ANSYS is the only software we are using currently. But
no,
friends, there are some using Abacus and all.
Okay, but what all softwares you have learned in your course?
We know to use ST. Estim is like a Malaysian version of Orient software.
Okay, for designing the structures, which software do you use?
Yeah. For designing the structure, Estim. It's a Malaysian product.
Okay.
But quite easy to use.
Okay, it is your own, like that own country's software.
Based on Eurocode.
Eurocode, okay. Means.
So
okay.
Others also can use that thing.
Uh-huh. But we usually use ETABS.
ETABS, yeah, ETABS also, people over here using ETABS also, but in the university we are exposed to STM.
Okay. We have ETABS, SAP, and StatPro also is good.
StatPro also was teach to us.
Yeah, I think the foundation is same, but your code in Eurocode, it will be designed according to your conditions there. In Indian code, it will be according to Indian code and practice. Eurocode, some design concepts little change. Okay, they use some ultimate load method. We use working stress method. We use limit state method actually. There they use ultimate load method for designing. Some changes will be there. So you're graduating this year.
Yeah, this year and should be graduating.
Okay. So I think this will take time a little bit. Just try this, okay? Shanmugam, you can try this. If you are getting some error, no, you just mail me. Okay. Hello.
The solver engine was unable to converge on a solution.
The solver engine was unable to
converge on a solution for the non-linear problem. So I searched online and I couldn't find a solution for this error, and I've been getting it constantly.
Okay. So solver, the solver error, in the sense, what you have to do is, one thing you have to change is, you have to change the time of analysis. Okay, you can just make a note, you just change the time, means whatever I showed, no, in time, analysis time. Are you able to see my screen now? No.
Yes.
Okay, I'll just show that here. I'll take the static. Structural. Which model shall I consider? Now what you do, now you just come back to the analysis settings here.
Analysis settings.
Yeah. There The no load step, the graph, everything is there. Number of steps.
Number of steps.
No, there itself in the details only. Here what you do, just move.
Reduce it, is it?
Just you reduce the time step, or what you do, analysis time here, autos time stepping on you have done, okay. I think you have to make it off, autos time stepping. You make it off, okay, you make that off. Then what will happen, it will go on updating, no? So it will become, it will take lot of time. And now you just check once again, okay?
Okay, sure.
Okay, you just check again some doubts you are playing, you just see. Okay, so I think, so again some error is coming. Warning, okay.
So there's a lot of warnings.
Yeah. Again error.
Yeah.
No, I think error came again. And then
it's a different
internal one. Wait. An internal solution magnitude was exceeded. Please check your environment for load value something. It's telling that you have provided some unrealistic load value, or there is no support condition. So just check your force. What is there? How much force you have given? Tabular data. So
reduce it maybe.
One thing, like what is your load type, like you want a continuous load, or you want to apply load and then lift that load and unload,
say, incrementally, like slowly increasing,
you want
gradually
increasing. Okay, then it's correct, not a problem. So 15 means 1000 means 15 kilonewton, 30 kilonewton. It's not a very long, it's not good. But what is the direction of load? Just check this.
Let me check.
Just check the direction where you have applied. It should be downward, no?
Oh yeah.
And you make your vector, see, just come here, make it component wise here, come back to the vector defined by, make it component. And now
also
you, not x, not minus y, minus you put, minus you have to put, or it's minus 15, again minus 30,000. Okay, now,
it seems to be,
okay. Please see the top for help system point. Internal solution magnitude was exceeded. So magnitude was exceeded. So above that there is a warning, no? Just open that once. Although the solution failed to
partially, I think.
At this wait, just at all time points, partial results at some points have been able to solve. Just check the deformation, total deformation.
There is still deformation actually. I think it's too high, if I'm not mistaken.
Maybe
the structure already exceeded its sustain.
So just one thing, directional deformation check. This is fine now. So 2.149 mm is fine, no?
Yes.
This
should be
Because
our study is actually to determine the deformation experienced by the beam.
So you have not got complete solution now, because some error is there, no? That if you remove only, you'll get the accurate results actually.
For other models, I could run it with success, but the value is actually very small comparative to the paper that we, the journal that we are trying to verify.
Okay. Actually, value is less. What we are getting is less compared to paper, right? What do you mean to say?
The paper was supposed to get around 36 mm, but I only obtained 1.7.
Okay, a lot of difference. Again, I think some here only regarding contact the penetration and other things, that thing itself is acting, I think. Where you applied load here in this model, you are showing it to me now, where you applied?
Yeah. Look,
exactly here, okay.
Sir, is there actually like an option in NCIS where we could put a value for the ductile damage, like in the vectors?
I don't know. Just come again, one second. Tell me.
I see some of my friends doing abacus. They have this option to key in a value for their ductile damage.
Ductile damage.
Yes.
Means you should you want to specify damage.
Yes, because for theirs, they are trying to get roughly the same study also, like to determine the deflection. So once they apply this option, the ductile damage, they are able to get a higher deflection. And for this, we couldn't actually, I couldn't find the option for ductile damage.
No, there's an option in the damage. There's an option here. Actually, in damage, there's an option. You can check here where like static. Wait, select that, insert. Ductile damage. So actually I have to go, like there's a meeting, huh?
Sorry,
yeah, yeah, whatever doubt is there, no, you can just come back to me later, okay? And just check with that answers form if you are getting some error a little bit, and it will take some time to analyze, and we'll see if you're getting the results, it's good. Otherwise, we'll sort it out. Okay. We'll.
Yes, sir. Really appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you. Fine. Good. Fine. Fine. Take care. Take care. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Bye. Bye.
Kishan, blue button.